Hello, my name is Ajit and in this video I will demonstrate how to install Active Directory on Synology storage. So as you know, Active Directory is one of the most popular services given by Microsoft team. So nowadays all the small business companies, large companies are using Active Directory on their local infrastructure. Basically, why we need Active Directory? Active Directory is used to manage our centralized user management, data management, as share files management, and even devices like printer and computer. So let's start with the configuration. First of all, we need to log into our Synology operating system, which is on the IP address 192.168.50.137. So let's log in with the administrator username and password. So once log in to the Synology box, there is a prerequisite for the Active Directory. Number one, make sure your LAN card has a static IP address. Number two, you need to install a package named Active Directory and DNS from the package center. So let's start with the network configuration. Let's check if we have a DHCP IP address or static IP address. We'll go to the main menu, control panel. Under the control panel, we'll go to the service called network. Then we'll go to network tab, network interface tab, and we can see LAN 1 is connected. We'll drop down that. I will see we are not choosing a DHCP address, so that means this is a static IP address. So number two, we need to check the DNS entries. So make sure you are using the same DNS as the IP address of your Active Directory. What I'll do, I'll just add a DNS of the internet, so to download the packages. So click apply. So next step is you need to go to the package center. So under the package center, you can search the package name called Active Directory from the search bar. So you can search the package from here also. Second option is you can go to the categories under the all packages, business. You can see the package name is Active Directory server. We click on install. So when installing Active Directory server, it will automatically install a DNS server because it is a dependency of Active Directory. If there is no DNS server in the network or on the server, the Active Directory will not work on your local on-premise. So we need to install DNS server. Click yes. It will download the DNS server package first, then after that it will install Active Directory package on the Synology OS. So we'll use the default volume for the installation. Next, apply. Now the DNS package is installed. Next step is it will install Active Directory package on the Synology operating system. Now it's downloading the Active Directory package. Again, we will use the default volume for the installation. Next, apply. Active Directory server package is installed on the computer. Now let's close this package center console. We'll go to a main menu. Under the main menu, you can see the DNS server and Active Server services are installed. Now we need to configure a first domain on your network. So let's click on Active Directory server. Click on next. So domain name, I'm giving thinkit.local. Thinkit is our workgroup name. Password. Next, apply. So to make sure you have a fresh installation of Synology and you are not running a domain name called thinkit.local on any of your local on-premise server. So now we are using this Synology box to make as a domain controller for your user management. Now your domain is installed on your Synology box. You can see thinkit.local is installed. So next step is we need to verify that the domain is installed properly. We'll go to the DNS entries, go to the main menu under the DNS. You will see it will automatically create a forward zone with the name of thinkit.local. We'll double click on that. And we will see all the Active Directory related entries under the thinkit.local forward zone. So you can see our A record is thinkit.local, which is pointed to 192.168.50.137, which is the IP address of our Synology box and our Active Directory. So next finishes. So this is the way you can install a Active Directory on your Synology box. So next step is let's join a computer to the Active Directory called thinkit.local. So I have a remote server. It's a server 2012 R2. So now I will join this operating system to the domain. So you can use any client. It should be a Windows 8, 7, 10 or any server. You can join to the Synology Active Directory services. So first of all, you make sure your network configuration is configured static or DHCP by using those settings. So I'm opening the network card settings. I'll go to the internet, right click and status. You can see I've given the details. The DNS server address is 192.168.50.137, which is the IP address of your Active Directory. Now I'm closing this. I'll go to the My Computer. Right click to the My Computer, Properties. Under the Properties, I will go to under the computer name, Change Settings. I click on change, then I'll give my domain name. Domain name is thinkit.local. Press OK. So it will ask for the username and password. So here you need to give the Active Directory username and password. Press OK. So you can see your computer is now joined to thinkit.local domain. So it will ask for the reboot. Let's reboot this machine. Close. Restart now. So once your client machine is rebooted, you will see the entries of the machine under your DNS services. Let's again we open DNS server. We'll go to the zone called thinkit.local. Double click on that. So now there are total number of items are 19. So once your client machine is rebooted, you will see your entries are updated to 20 and you will see the computer name of a client machine and the IP address of client machine under the DNS zone entries. Your client operating system is rebooted. Let's refresh the settings. So once you refresh, you will see your item is updated to 20 items. So you can scroll down and see your Windows Server domain name entry is under the zone called thinkit.local. So it has given the Windows Server.thinkit.local, A record, and information, the IP address of that particular server and operating system is 192.168.50.134. So that's mean your client operating system is joined to the domain called thinkit.local. So let's log into the client machine via a thinkit administrator username and password. We'll open that with the same IP address, or you can use the fully qualified domain names, which is known as Windows Server.thinkit.local. On connect. So now it will ask for the username and password. So I'll go to the more choices. I'll go to thinkit.local/administrator password. So accept the certificate. Yes. So you can see it is applying all the settings related to the domains thinkit.local. So we are on the computer or on the operating system with the name of domain thinkit.local. So once we load all the profile, we will go to the My Computer settings and check the name of the operating system. So we need to go to My Computer, right click, properties, and you can see your full computer name is changed to windowserver.thinkit.local. So now this means your computer is joined to the domain called thinkit.local. So you can go to the change settings and confirm the settings once again. If you click on change, you can see the domain is thinkit.local. So this is the way you join your client computer to the Synology Active Directory. So in this video I have demonstrated how to install Active Directory services on the Synology box and how to join any client computer to the particular domain. So thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe.